So I'm gonna grab my, let's see if I can find it. Oh yeah, I had a project. I didn't know I started it a couple of years ago, and because this is my only I can only knit this way, you see. And as you see, I do it in a couple of days, and it's not very regular. As you can see, it's very irregular. Sometimes it jumps up and sometimes it jumps down. Sometimes it creates holes. But then I thought to myself, why is there holes in my piece? And I thought to myself, oh yeah, I was dumb enough to sometimes when I'm done with one row and I'm scared that I'm losing my piece of work, so I grabbed my knitting needles and then I push the ball in there, and suddenly I realized that the ball was cut in two threads, so I didn't want that. So I thought to myself, I'm gonna cut it through my work. And that's what I created the holes. But that's not the thing that I'm talking about. The thing is, I can only knit this way. And I thought to myself, maybe I can hide this way of knitting by using not the straightforward thread. So I thought to myself, if I use some balls of yarn that has some kind of structure, and I'm gonna show you. I have this bag, a very old bag. I think it's a bit dusty even. I have this one in green, in frog green, and this one in blue. I don't know where the frog green is. I think somewhere in my boxes. But these are the oldest balls of yarn that I got from my aunt, because it's not only my school learned. When I was very young, I think 7 years old, 8 years old, when they teach all the children to knit and to crochet. My aunt started with crocheting, and she had this leftover yarn. Looking at these balls of yarn, the blue one, and I know I have the green one too, but I don't know, it's somewhere in my boxes. Over the years, I collected some balls of yarns. These are from my oldest son. These I bought a couple of years ago at Action. And Action had also this one. And I bought these two at the same time. And I always buy yarn, just one ball. Or if I'm, how do you say, generous enough. If I feel so rich, I will buy two balls of yarns. But mostly I buy just one, because it's just for one project and then I'm done. And I don't know how long the balls of yarn is. I know it says here how long it is. But it depends on how your piece is knitted together. So, like I said, I found this one and I fell in love. It's also for my Barbie that I don't own. I'm making pieces for it. And I just started with this piece. I think I've started like over 5-8 times. And then finally I just stuck to it. And I love this piece. And what I did not love is both ends has this. And that's, I don't know. I have to show it to you in my box. So in my box, sorry. In my box, I have these knitting needles, but they're quite thick. How much do I have? 3, 5, 6, 7. 7, and then this one is 8. Okay, but like I said, it has the beginning and the ending is like this, so I'm scared. That's why I didn't try to do very long pieces. Oh, sorry. I don't try to make the pieces very long, so I thought I'm just start somewhere and we'll see where we end, because I have only one ball of yarn of this one. But I started another project while doing this one. I started this one. But the problem with this one is, this is the longer piece I ever have. So, I have to show you, sorry. So, it's like this. But because the loops here, I can't see how many loops I have, because this piece I have done like more than 5 years ago. So I my knitting stick it couldn't hold this very long piece. As you can see, it's very long and it has no stop at the beginning or stop at the end. So that's why I stopped knitting this piece. And then, as you can see, I got in a pickle and as you can see, I have a knot here with the other ball of yarn, and that's why I didn't continue anymore, and I regret it. Why I lost it's such a beautiful piece to make for something for my Barbie that I want to buy soon, some kind of shawl or neck fake fur thing. I don't know how to call it, because I don't know at the end how it looks like. So let me start at the beginning. I start with something. I don't know how it will, or what my goal is, and how it looks at the end. So at the time I'm almost finished and I think it's good enough, I stop. And then it's the end result piece. But as you know, as you can see, I have things here that I start. I push my thing on. I start with something and then suddenly I stop because I think out of boredom, or I'm not interested anymore. So now I regret that I took out the needle and I unravel half of it now. Now I have to start all over. But I think it's also a good thing, because I don't know where the loops are. I can't see it. And because I don't want to use these kind of needles anymore, or I have to buy something, some like a cube or a ball here, to stop my work sliding out of the back door. So luckily I bought, like I said, these needles. I grabbed the wrong needle. This needle that has in the end some kind of cube that's already how do you touch the metal part, the stick part. And I bought also at at Action a tube of needles, and there are some different sizes, I mean thickness. So I'm glad that I bought these, because that's the reason I bought these. They have at the end some kind of things, so my work don't slide the other part out. So I have to unravel this thing, because at least I know what it looks like, and I like this kind of softness and fluffiness. It's very fluffy, also with this thing. And I started to buy more yarn. This I thought I wanted to do a project. I have yarn here to make a scarf, but that was my first project, my very, very first project. So I started somewhere and I stopped and I didn't carry on. So then I finally found a book. Like I said, I only can do this stitching or knitting. Luckily, I have found a book that shows me in a 1970s, 1980s way how to do the kind of other kind of patterns. And that's what I want to learn. I want to learn other patterns. So I'm looking at this book. I'm like, hey, now I have this kind of balls of yarn. Okay, it's not the same color, but I have those. And then you look like, oh yeah, that's the pattern that I only know. I can only do this one. So I thought, I want to learn more. You know, these, like I showed you, I want to learn these. I want to learn all the cable pattern. So luckily they show me how to do it, but I have to be consistent. And that's the, and patient. Patience and consistency is not my thing. But I'm glad I have found this book so I can do something with it. But I'm gonna show you something. Last year I got more yarn. I'm gonna show you. I'm gonna get it out of the bag. Let's see, what did I get? Oh yeah, it was at Seiman. I found these, as you can see. Seiman. I think once I've done a piece of work, it will be very beautiful, like these ones. So I like the structure and uniqueness of the threading. So I have this one, also one ball of yarn. Let me see. I bought more, but I need to find out. I got also this one last year, the Christmas one. And because I like this one, but I wanted also the pink one. And I'm also, I like the teddy bear. So I got the teddy bear, but I only have the one ball of yarn. Let me see. Oh yeah, I've got like I said, I only bought this last year, so this year they are not anymore in the stores. I found these ones, the gray and the pink one. And I found another one also at Seiman, this one. Almost like this, the Christmas, but more in brown. There were other colors, but I said to myself, I can only afford these, and that's all. I got last two yarns from, Action, yes, these two from Action, and this one also from Action. So, like I said, these are only one ball of yarn. I don't bought the second one, so I only want to make just one unique piece of clothing for my non I don't want to say non-existent Barbie, but it's just Barbie that I have not bought yet or not owned yet. So yeah, I have, as you can see here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and then 12. I don't know, is this 13? And then underneath this 14, 15. So, where is the other one? 16. So, this is almost done. I think this is the only project that's almost done. So, I have 16 projects here of clothing that I want to make. I don't know what kind of clothing, but... So, I think this, I don't know this year, because, like I said, half of the balls are from last year. And, oh yeah, I still have yarns here in the bag that I bought previously. And then this one, I want to make a shawl. Yeah, I know. I'm going to be so busy this year. Well, in case I don't make all of them something of... can still leave it for next year's project, but I'm gonna be so happy because at least I have finished one project. This is almost done also. If I just continue to knit, I will be done, and then this one I have to unravel it and start all over again, but at least I know what kind of length I want to have. So I'm going to be so, so happy. So I have here like 1, 2. And this one is, like I said, done. 3 projects, that's almost done. Okay, this one I have to restart. So, my question is, are you starting knitting as well as me? Well, this is... This is a project that I started somewhere and I didn't finish. At least I'm happy with this one. So I want to make, like I said, a Disney ball gown dress. Semi English, you know, Jane Austen period. But I need to make underneath the cotton... underskirts, and I believe in those days you had at least 1 underskirt or 2 underskirts, so I have to make cotton underskirts for these, so, or some kind of fabric. But I'm so happy, so thank you for watching. Keep on knitting and try to at least finish, you know. That's what I want to do. At least try to finish one dress or one piece of clothing, and then I can continue with the other one. But as you can see, I took it out of the darkness and bring it into the light. So happy with those. Okay, bye everyone.